A word from the developer. We are opening up the possibilities for Franco to take damage path. Damage path?
Real fighter never runs. Legendary.
Yeah, boy.
So there are some very interesting changes to Franco. He's getting both nerf and a buff. But what truly is? Let's find out. Let me walk you through all the changes he got in this patch note. His passive now has an additional effect. For every second of not taking any damage, Franco starts getting stacks. Each stack increasing his next skill damage by 5%, max stat 50%. The stacks keep stacking unless you take damage. It's okay to keep doing damage, the stacks will still stack up. The first skill based damage is decreased from 800 in the late game to 650. But we add 50% from the passive stack. It will be around 975, which is an overall buff. His second skill can no longer crit anymore. Ultimate damage is also significantly reduced from 100 per stack to 70 in the late game. While people may think this is a nerf, as only the first damage from ultimate will have stack benefit, while other just normal damage. Well, no. All the slashes, Franco does will have bonus damage from stack. So what's interesting with these changes? The most fearsome weapon only Franco possesses. The hook. Minsitar has one as well, but it's not threatening. Legendary. His hook scales his level with a physical attack, so the more attack you build, the higher his hook damage be. Now rather than being afraid of being pulled, you also need to be afraid of getting instant kill. Let's test the damage of Franco and see if he is capable of one shooting enemies. At level 1, no gears, he does 712 damage. For right at the start of the game, this is very high. At level 15, no attack gear, he does 1180 damage. Not much, but this is the tank build damage. Also, that was just hooked. Considering a full combo is done, you might die to Franco alone. If we take a normal burst damage build, which most fighters use, the hook damage rises to 2000. This is a threat in itself. Legendary. A hook pull and passive damage of Endless and Heptaseas might knock a target down. Legendary. Let's bring out the Blade of Despair. That was almost a shot. The damage is crazy after all the despairs added in the build. Let's add a potion and I think it should be enough. Yep, one shot Franco is on. So this was the Franco update. What do you think? Is it too strong now? Let us know in the comments. Thank you for watching. Keep supporting Kazuki Official.